Today's video is sponsored by Famous Faces and Funnies, located in Melbourne, Florida, as well as Docking Bay 94, located in Boca Raton, Florida, and Ian's Display Stands. Click on the link below, and remember, shipping is nationwide. Alright, I posted about this on my Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, but I've been revisiting, let me put the Medal of Honor Frontline. And I've been playing both the PlayStation 2 version and the original Xbox version at the same time. It's the same game. It's just that, you know, the feel of it, I have to say, like, while the Xbox, the PlayStation 2 is fun and I'm more used to it, the Xbox version I'm playing for the first time. And the controls seem to be a little bit better because, you know, you have the old Xbox controller. So, yeah, this is just a simple, like, for shits and giggles, a playthrough of one level. I'd be here for hours if I played the entire game. So, but you forget how good these games were and how the genre has, like, jump so far. And then also the other thing is, you know, we have a guy who's sitting in the White House that called these World War II veterans losers. I don't know, walking into something like this, I don't think you're a loser, man. You got balls of steel. Again, the Xbox controls just feel a little bit more fluid than the PlayStation 2. Man, you gotta hand it to these veterans, what they went through in World War II. And they were, again, this is before drones and all this other stuff that modern warfare is. I mean, these guys had to, like, walk into death, essentially. I can't believe you called them that. Thank you. I don't know how to kill that thing. Oh well. I guess Bazooka was in. The other thing with war is like, yeah, you know, there's no such thing as a medical canteen, like, you know, that restores your health. Thank you. Get up in the power. Full health. I was shooting my own guy.
Fire a will! Come in!
Obviously, I have to go to the find this bell tower. Back and find this bell tower. Every time I play this game, I forget where the hell this bell tower is. I mean, it's been a while. That must be a crazy feeling, just manning death from above and just hosing down all these lives. I still can't believe he called those guys losers, man. I'm not trying to be political in this thing, but, you know. Well, since we're on playing, I'll tell you a quick story. Me and my wife were probably going to write this into a story, but I was a junior or a sophomore at Rutgers University, and my job was I was a physical therapist assistant. So I had to, every time the physical therapist would assign a patient a group of activities or rehabilitation stuff, I would walk them through their physical therapy. And one time there was this elderly lady, and, you know, she was on the arm bike, which is basically like she was working out her shoulder rotator cuff, and I noticed a tattoo on her forearm. And I was like, Mrs., I forgot her name, but Mrs. such and such, you have a tattoo on your arm. And she was like, sweet child. I was totally oblivious to it. Come on, dude, move. And the physical therapist called me over and was like, she's like, yeah, some Nazi scum did that to her when she was 9 years old. And it dawned on me that she was a Holocaust survivor. And I was like, you read about it and you hear about it, but meeting a Holocaust survivor face to face was just, I was instantly sad. I could feel her suffering. And I started crying, because who would do that to another human being? Like burning them, whatever, all the stories and stuff that we hear of the atrocities of the Nazis, just all of a sudden, I felt everything, and she saw me, and she was just like, she gave me a hug. And I wish the world saw that. So that's the level in this I wanted to share. Again, this game is worth getting again if you haven't. If you're a retro gamer, but just playing this is just a shitload of fun. This is Shibu RU signing off.